time for us to have a conversation on our nutrition segment. And today we're going to be discussing a complete meal for Ghanaians, meal plan for Ghanaians. Now, our nutritionist, Akosi Akunedu Yarom, has joined us on the set, and we're going to have a conversation with her this morning. Good morning, Akosi. How are you?
Good morning, Koko. I'm fine. Yourself?
I'm really good. Fantastic. This is a nice spread that we have here.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Okay, so just like you said, we are discussing how our meals should be, like as Ghanaians.
Mm.
So sometimes you realize that I go like, Kweku, what are you having for lunch? What are you having for lunch? You are now going to think about it. You are not sure what you want to eat. People wake up with this mood and so, okay, I thought I wanted to have kinke, but I think I want something different.
Mm.
But as a nutritionist, I will always tell you to plan your meals.
Okay.
If you do plan your meals, you are so sure that my lunch break is 1 p.m. And no matter what I may need you to do for me at 1, you need to make sure you are having your lunch. So when you go elsewhere, when it's time to have lunch, no matter what you are bringing in, it is lunch break.
Okay.
But sometimes you realize that you ask the average Ghanaian, I ask you, Kweku, what time do you normally have your lunch? It becomes a problem. So depending on the time you wake up and the time you retire to bed, you need to make sure your meals are planned.
Okay.
So let's say that, Kweku, on a typical day, you wake up at 5 a.m. and then retire at 10 p.m. So I can decide to plan your meals in such a way that it is suiting everything as far as your needs are concerned. I need to know how you are doing as far as your vitals are concerned. So let's say I checked and realized that Kweku has a very good blood pressure. Your BP is okay. Every other thing is well. Now, Kweku wakes up at 5 a.m. So I can say that by 8:39, Kweku should have taken breakfast. At 11 a.m., you should have had your a.m. snack. By 1:30 latest or 1 p.m., you should have had your lunch. And then by 3:30 p.m., you should have had your p.m. snack. And then latest by 6:30 or 7, because you retire at 10 p.m., so it's like 3 hours interval, you should have had your supper. So that is what I would do for you. But I know Kweku has this kind of a schedule where he will enter CT, be on television until it is 10 a.m. So I would have to also factor that. So we are here to help you plan your meals.
Okay.
And I know that we'll go through it all as and when the questions come.
Okay. So let's go ahead.
Okay. So a typical Ghanaian breakfast.
Yes.
I am going for everything local.
Mm-hmm.
So we have Hausa cocoa. That is millet and sorghum porridge. And then we have wheat bread. I used wheat bread because wheat bread contains fiber. It is very good for people with heart issues. It is very good as far as you reducing your risk of diabetes also is concerned, because it doesn't have a lot of, carbohydrates in there. And so it's a very healthy alternative. We've spoken at length about glycemic index, and I've said that it's how faster what you eat is it's being converted into sugar. And so when we draw blood samples, that is how, when you do fasting blood sugar test, we find blood floating in your system. Wheat bread is a healthier alternative as far as bread is concerned. You should choose wheat bread over white bread.
Okay.
And a slice of bread is equivalent to the sardine tin size, so the tighter sardine tin size. That is a slice. So we have, this will be roughly 2-4 slices. So you should make sure you do 2 slices. Get a tighter sardine tin, and then make sure your bread is portioned as such. And then for the Hausa porridge, I can do 3-4 ladles of that. And then 4 ladles, I will use 2 cubes of sugar.
Mm.
There is something powerful about millet and sorghum. Millet-sorghum combination, very, very, very good as far as you taking care of postpartum depression is concerned. I met a mother on the ward, and she was facing, her back was facing her baby. Baby was crying. So I was like, when did you deliver? She was like, 2 days ago. I was like, 2 days ago? Your baby is crying. Is it that you've not heard? She was like, I am tired already. The baby keeps crying. And she had down there. So she was going through a whole lot. So I was like, oh, this lady is depressed. She's not even been discharged.
Yeah.
So I tried to encourage her. This is something you can eat and you will be taking care of that. I quickly want to run through because I don't want you to make the goodness in millet. It contains quercetin, that is example quercetin, which helps with your kidney and liver function. So taking our local Hausa cocoa, millet and sorghum porridge, you'll be doing your liver some good, and then your kidneys some good. And it's also good as far as our gut health is concerned, especially with people who have peptic ulcer. If you have peptic ulcer, you taking Hausa cocoa will help you because of the catechins in the millet. And then it also helps as far as reducing your risk of colon cancer. This American actor made colon cancer such a big thing, and if you are taking millet or Hausa cocoa, you know that you are doing yourself some good. Quickly to sorghum, it is also rich in vitamins and minerals. It contains magnesium, potassium, iron and zinc. We've spoken extensively about potassium, magnesium here. It takes care of stress. It takes care of anxiety. And I've spoken about postpartum depression.
Okay.
It is very good for women who just delivered. It is also rich in iron. Iron is very, very, very important for us as far as our blood health is concerned. And zinc. Corona made zinc such a big deal. Vitamin C zinc was such a big deal. So if you are taking simple, you can just walk to the street, give me Hausa cocoa with sugar, 1 cd, and you will be serving your body with something amazing. So that is it. And for the wheat bread, wheat is very good. I've spoken about it as far as you reducing your risk of diabetes is concerned. And even if you have the diabetes already, you are also gradually introducing glucose or sugar into your system. It is loaded in fiber, and so very good as far as gut health is also concerned, and taking care of constipation too is concerned.
Great. Fantastic. So we've had a good breakfast.
Yes.
Then it's time for lunch.
Okay, so for the breakfast, I want to add a bit of peanuts, a handful of peanuts to it, because our breakfast, sometimes when you try to see if it's balanced, it's not too balanced. So I would want to have a bit. So this salad, I can decide to let a little bit of the salad go with this so that I can have, I can satisfy the protocol as far as the four-star diet is concerned. I can make something balanced out of it. And then
so
you
what's
can
in the salad?
So we have
some mint leaves.
Yes, and then this is too? I asked for plain salad, and I'm glad they made plain salad. It's a plain salad. So you if tomatoes, onions, dandelion is what you have, you can slap in some few mints in there. Make your own salad. You don't have to do. We have a, some cabbage also in there. Last week we spoke about the cruciferous vegetables and the goodness. You can look for that episode and then appreciate. Thank you so much for being a good student. So we are twisting it. So that is for the breakfast. Peanut too. You can watch last 2 weeks' episodes. Last week's episodes we spoke about the benefits of peanuts. So we are moving on to lunch. And lunch, jollof is such a big deal in Ghana. Everybody loves jollof. So we are having jollof rice, and then we would want our plain vegetables to go with our jollof as well. And then we have shito here, or black pepper for the pepper lovers. I wouldn't have it with it. I am not a fan of pepper, but there are people who kind of feel nauseous if they don't have the pepper in there. So that is what we have. Chicken is very good. It's a healthy alternative as far as you taking care of your protein needs are concerned. Chicken is very good as far as calcium supply is concerned. Calcium is needed for the formation of strong bones and teeth. And so if you are taking chicken, it's very good. Chicken has choline and vitamin B6 in it, which the combination is very powerful as far as brain development in children is concerned. And the same thing is also good for the adults or the aged as far as cognitive ability or usage is concerned. So it works for the aged, it works for children. So I would say that chicken is very good as far as working for every person within the life cycle or the age brackets within the life cycle. Are concerned. Vegetables, we've spoken about it already. And pepper, well, it's something that it's a go-to. I can take it off and my meal will still be balanced. But, well, I think much will need to be done into it. It contains shrimps, it contains fish powder, but the cooking and how it has to burn to have this is what is making me think that maybe we've lost a lot out
in
of
the
it.
Process.
Yes, in the process.
The
and then we talk about rice. Rice is very good. Most people think because rice is kind of starchy, it is not too good to eat more. I wouldn't want you to enjoy everything here We can have two ladles leveled of rice because we have...
So this is too much for lunch?
This is too much for one person.
Okay.
Yeah, so depending on your needs, if I am dealing with an athlete, definitely it will be different from somebody who is sedentary. Okay. If I have to sit at a particular place for a very long time, I wouldn't need to eat as an athlete would do.
Okay.
So you make sure if you are somebody who is sedentary, you work with two ladles leveled, and then one drumstick is okay for you with some vegetable and your shito to go with.
Okay.
So that will be for lunch. Rice is very good as far as iron supply is concerned. Rice is very good depending on the brand you are using. So I am here for Ghana rice. If you are using Ghana rice, nothing has been taken off. You have the brand, you have the germ, you have the endosperm in there. And so you have every goodness as far as the rice is concerned in there. It contains, I've spoken about iron already, and then it is also good as far as energy is concerned because obviously it falls under carbohydrate or the staples, which is our main fuel as far as energy is concerned. So that is it. Breakfast, lunch, already exciting.
Okay.
And then I didn't speak about in between. So for between breakfast and lunch, we will have something like a fruit.
Okay.
I would choose apple.
Okay.
Okay.
Why
so
apple?
Apple is very good for the heart.
Okay, super.
Apple,
I like that.
Very good for the heart. And then it's very effective for people trying to lose weight. Apple contains vitamin C and antioxidants, which is very good as far as reducing your risk of some non-communicable diseases are concerned, especially diabetes.
All right.
So if it's a heart healthy food, it means that it does you good as far as your blood pressure is concerned and affects your overall health and your risk of certain heart conditions or heart conditions are taken care of.
Fantastic.
So that is what I want to have in between. And then for our supper, we are going for cocoa.
Okay. Ripe plantain.
Ripe plantain.
Super.
Yes, with egg stew. So
it's a very good combination.
Yes.
I like
egg. So this is we are toning down. I always say that let your heaviest meal be for lunch because your body will be able to exhaust
process
every energy. Yes.
That,
thank you so much, biochemist.
So question is, when you look at heavy, you're looking more, not necessarily at volume per se, but at more at carbohydrate load, isn't it?
So
would that be correct?
I am looking at nutrition.
Okay.
That is the most important thing. In our part here, our focus is on the fufu. So if I ask you, what did you have for lunch? You are quick to say, I had fufu with chicken soup.
You mentioned the carbohydrate before we talked about the protein.
But in nutrition, the main meal is where much of the nutrients is sitting. So if I ask you, what are you having for lunch? You don't have to tell me fufu. You have to tell me I'm having chicken lice soup with fufu.
Okay.
Because fufu is the accompaniment and the chicken lice soup is
the
main meal.
Nutritional base.
Yes, so that is the main meal. So that is how it has to be. So you'd have to make sure fufu, my fist size, based on my size, your fist size is the guide. But you are allowed to go a little bit over that.
I know,
but ideally I will work with my fist size.
I know a lot of people in the room right
your
now
will guy
will
just said,
will fight with you. Yeah,
I know, but that is what your body will need as far as the fufu is concerned, because it's not just the fufu. You have chicken lice soup, you have some nutrients also coming, you use tomato, onion, pepper, you added garlic, ginger, and a whole lot of things, salt. So your body is appreciating a lot of other stuff and not just the carbohydrate, because a lot is causing harm. That is why it is being tagged as something that is evil, but it's a necessary evil. It's not evil.
Okay.
So that is it for the egg stew and for the plantain. Plantain, excellent source of potassium. Potassium, very good as far as checking your blood pressure levels are concerned. Magnesium, potassium, I think on this show it's been preached more than any other platform I can think of as far as magnesium, the goodness in magnesium and potassium are concerned. Egg stew, very, very excellent. Egg is a top-notch food as far as protein is concerned. It works for all persons within the life cycle. It is very good for person trying to even lose weight. Last week we spoke about it. So it's also a healthier option for people who are not comfortable with the animal flesh or red meat. So yes, we having this simple Ghanaian cuisines, we are pumping goodness into our system. For the fruits, we have oranges also here. So orange, very great as far as vitamin C is concerned. Corona has made vitamin C such a big thing. And so if you are having an orange, you should know that you are serving your body some goodness. We've spoken about berries in our other presentations. We spoke about the goodness in there. We have strawberries here. If you can afford, why not? It's very good as far as taking care of stress. It's good as far as age-related issues and conditions are concerned. Berries are a great source of antioxidants, and then they are loaded as far as their ability to take care of free radicals are concerned. And we know that free radicals are linked with cancer. So if you are having strawberries and you can afford them, you can slap one or two in your smoothies. Watermelon. You can decide to have watermelon, or pineapple. You can have pineapple. Or you can decide to have, let's say, pineapple apple juice, where you have pineapple, you have apple there to make something good, and then just serve yourself a glass of juice out of it. We are using pineapple is acidic, apple not too acidic. When we're discussing fruits, we discussed sweet, acidic, and non-acidic, semi-acidic. So you should know how to even combine fruits when you want to make smoothies or you want to make juices. Watermelon is very good as far as hydration is concerned. Watermelon is loaded as far as magnesium is concerned. It helps take care of stress. It helps you with a lot of goodness. Pineapple is an enhancer as far as iron absorption is concerned. So I can decide to have, let's say, a little bit of pineapple juice or watermelon juice with my jollof rice, and I will be able to absorb every iron in the chicken I have here. So you should eat with style. And then we have the greens. You can make a green smoothie.
So green smoothie, this is exciting.
Out of it. Last week we spoke extensively about the benefits of greens. So you can just have these spinach, you can have cucumber, you can twist it how you want. We have, cucumber is also here. So you can do this. And then you can use watermelon juice or coconut water to make a powerful smoothie out of it. And this is what something you can find around. You will be doing your body some good. So that is what we have.
I think it's
for the green smoothie.
So I think it's important to hit on that note that instead of fetching water to add to your leaves for the smoothie, use
For the green smoothie on your screens, you can use coconut water or you can use the watermelon juice to do it.
Fantastic. Fantastic. No, I like it. Watermelons. Now, I know that some people don't like the seeds. Do you have any comment about that?
I think you've asked me. This is the second or third time you've asked me.
Because I know that a lot of Ghanaians don't like the seeds.
Well, there is a school of thought that believes that there is some health benefit. I always say that until I have concrete evidence to back certain claims. For now, I know that it has served some people some benefits, a lot of benefits. But until there is enough research to really be firm on that ground, I wouldn't take the seed. Don't decide to be like me. I am not comfortable with it. If you are comfortable with it, it's at your own discretion. But I know that there is some amount of benefit in there. But until recent, there is a lot of research to say, just like apple now, it said egg, there is enough research to back that.
But you know my
that.
Argument.
I know.
You know my argument, right? My argument is very simple.
Tell us.
One of the species of melon, is what gives us agushi. The seed of melon gives us agushi.
And agushi is very
agushi
good.
Is
as far
so good
as legumes
for you,
are concerned.
Then hello, it just stands,
like
to, it just stands to, you know, to say
who
that.
Who knows? After this show, maybe I'll be taking some seeds.
Well,
but I'm saying that do it. It's at your own discretion.
Yeah.
Well, what may work for Kweku may never work for me. And most of the things we sit here to talk about, at the end of the day, if you are not tolerating wheat for some reasons, there are people, the blood group and food issues, I don't want to go there, but there are people who simply may not tolerate wheat or other food items. So no matter how good it is, I wouldn't want to push wheat bread on you.
Yeah.
You can find that same nutrient in another food.
Something else.
Yes.
Yeah. Fantastic. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
We've been speaking with Akosua Kunedi Yadom, who is a state registered nutritionist. And, you know, we've been going on about the Ghanaian dishes, the things that we have available right here in Aspies. Of course, this segment was brought to us by the Farmers Market. Akosua, before we go, how can people reach you?
Okay, so on Instagram, at The Nutritionist Akosua, on Instagram, at The Nutritionist Akosua, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Nutritionist Akosua, and you can reach me on 0243-350206.
All right, super. Well, that was been the nutrition segment.
Hi there. We hope you enjoyed the show.
Make sure to subscribe, like, comment, and share with your friends.
This is Breakfast Daily on City TV.
Join the Breakfast Daily team Monday through Fridays from 7:30 a.m. to 10. Join us for breakfast daily, only on City TV.